You might have heard of a doppelganger, but what about an evil twin? Howdy, I'm Andy Lee with Family History Fanatics, where we help you understand your DNA, climb your family tree, and write your ancestor story along the way. This is a segment of DNA. Be sure to subscribe to our channel and click on that bell if you want to be notified about upcoming episodes. Some of you may have met my twin, Phil. Now, he's not really an evil twin. He's pretty much harmless. But in GEDmatch, you can use your DNA to create an evil twin. And that's perfect for Halloween just coming up. On GEDmatch, I have logged in, and if I scroll down, I'm going to see that the free tools are under DNA applications, but your evil twin, you need to be a tier one member. So if we scroll down a little bit further, we get to our tier one tools, and we can see there is my evil twin. This is the tool we're going to be using today. My evil twin is sort of like phasing, except that instead of seeing what parts of DNA you got from your mom and what parts of DNA you got from your dad, my evil twin tells you what parts of DNA you didn't get from your mom and what parts of DNA you didn't get from your dad. So in order to use this tool, you need to have your kit, and then you need to have at least one parent kit. And if you have two parent kits, that's even better. Now, it does divide out into your father's kit and your mother's kit. So if you only have one parent, make sure that you select the correct parent. Otherwise, it's going to give you an error saying that it's not the right sex of that person. Now, this idea was from Tim Jansen originally, and special thanks to him for thinking about, hey, this data actually can be useful for DNA research as well. And it only takes a few seconds and your kit has been created. Now, it's going to have a number of your kit number and then M2 for your maternal side and P2 for your paternal side. Now, the phase kits are going to be M1 or P1 if you've used the phasing tool to phase your DNA. As with all of the kits, whether you upload them or create them, they are ready for one-to-one comparison immediately, and then within a couple of days, you'll be able to use the one-to-many. But let's go take a look at our one-to-one to see how this DNA looks. So the first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to compare my maternal phase kit to my maternal evil twin kit. Now, since one kit is what I did inherit from my mom, and the other kit is what I didn't inherit from my mom, there should be no matching segments on that DNA unless there is some multiple relationships or some endogamy in my background. Now, I don't have any known endogamy in my background, so let me just go down and scroll through here, and we can see, yeah, it's looking like there are no matching segments anywhere. So it found no matching segments in all of that comparison. So my evil twin and me, we don't share any DNA from my maternal side. Now let's take a look at my paternal side and see if my evil twin and I share any DNA. And no, we don't share any DNA. So this is exactly what we would expect for people who don't have multiple relationships in their family or endogamy in their family that is somewhat recent. Your evil twin and your phase kits should be the exact opposites of each other. Next, I want to compare my phase kit and my evil twin kit to my grandfather. My father didn't receive all of my grandfather's DNA, so I don't expect to see everything being covered here, but what I do expect to see is that in the places where there was DNA inherited, it's not going to overlap between my phase kit and my evil twin kit because they should be the opposite. So as I'm looking right here, I can see on chromosome number 2, there is the phase kit has a little bit, which is a match with my grandfather. And then there's the evil twin kit, which shows all the rest of it that is a match with my grandfather as well. So I didn't inherit where this light blue is, but I did inherit where this dark blue is. And we can see that in various places on this map. As we go down, there's not sections that are big overlapping. You might see just the tail ends of sections overlapping. But the most part, these are all segments that don't overlap between these two, because they shouldn't, because they are looking at different DNA. Next, I'm going to look at a distant cousin. And this is comparing his DNA to my father, and then it's also comparing it to my face kit and to my evil twin kit. So as I'm going down, I can see a couple of things. So first off, on this first chromosome number 7, there is a little green bar that is here for numbers 1 and 2, which is going to be my evil twin kit. So I didn't inherit that part, but my dad did. And so that's picking up that. But then as I go further to the next chromosome, I can see that there is a part that I inherited and my dad inherited as well. Down further on chromosome number 13, here's another one that my evil twin got that I didn't get. So this is another segment that is lost between my father and me. And then finally on the last chromosome number 16, this is another segment that is lost between me and my father. My evil twin inherited it, but I didn't inherit it. Evil twins are a phased kit. There are some specialized uses where you would use them in genetic genealogy that I'll make in videos later on. But for right now, just understand that it is taking the DNA that you didn't inherit from each of your parents and creating kits that look like that. So if you have any questions about your evil twin, put it in the comments below and I'll try to answer it. And if you like this video, be sure to give it a thumbs up and share it with all your friends.